Please stand.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
As our sister Jessica has died with the Lord, so may she live with him in glory. Let us pray. Listen kindly to our prayers, O Lord, as our faith in your Son, raised from the dead, is deepened. May our hope of resurrection for your departed servant Jessica also find new strength. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the book of Revelation. I, John, saw a new heaven and a new earth. The former heaven and the former earth had passed away, and the sea was no more. I saw the holy city, a new Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God, prepared as a new bride adorned for her husband. I heard a loud voice from the throne saying, "Behold, God's dwelling is with the human race. He is well with them, and they will be his people. And God himself will always be with them as their God. He will wipe away every tear from their eyes, and there shall be no more death, or mourning, or wailing, or pain, for the old order has passed away." The one who sat on the throne said, "Behold, I make all things new. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. To the thirsty, I will give a gift from the spring of life-giving water. The victor will inherit these gifts, and I shall be his God, and he will be my son." The word of the Lord. A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, we know that the one who raised the Lord Jesus will also raise with Jesus and place us with you in his presence. Everything indeed is for you, so that the grace bestowed in abundance on more and more people may cause the thanksgiving to overflow for the glory of God. Therefore, we are not discouraged. Rather, although our outer self is wasting away, our inner self is being renewed day by day. For this momentary light affliction is producing for us an internal weight of glory beyond all comparison. As we look not to what is seen, but to what is unseen, for what is seen is transitory, but what is unseen is eternal. For we know, what if our earthly dwelling, a tent, should be destroyed? We have a building from God, a dwelling not made with hands, eternal in heaven. The word of the Lord.
Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to the crowds, "Everything that the Father gives me will come to me, and I will not reject anyone who comes to me, because I came down from heaven not to do my own will, but the will of the one who sent me. And this is the will of the one who sent me, that I should not lose anything of what he gave me, but that I should raise it on the last day. For this is the will of my Father, that everyone who sees the Son and believes in him may have eternal life, and I shall raise him on the last day." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you. Please be seated.
To Mark, to Jessica's children, the entire Boesmiller family, the firefighters representing your various departments, and all of Jessica's family and friends here gathered, please allow me to express my condolences on behalf of St. Mark Catholic Church and all of our parishioners, as well as to assure you of our continued prayers during this time. St. Paul writes in 2 Corinthians, "We are not discouraged. Rather, although our outer self is wasting away, our inner self is being renewed day by day." On a day like today, it may seem impossible not to be discouraged. The passing of a beloved wife, a daughter, a friend, so young. It might seem like discouragement is the only reasonable response, the only possible response. I like to think that Jessica taught us different. In times like these, it is so hard to believe the words of Scripture, that what is seen is transitory and passing, but what is unseen is eternal. I had the privilege of visiting Jessica on Easter Sunday to celebrate the sacrament of anointing of the sick and bring her Holy Communion. I couldn't have helped but be inspired by her hope and her faith in Christ, even in the midst of great suffering. After receiving Holy Communion, she simply told me of the peace and the joy that was in her soul. Physically, she was in decline. What was seen was passing away. But that did not affect what was unseen, her strong faith, her confidence in Christ, her Savior. She described for me how much she loved those mountains of North Carolina. So many happy memories there with family and with friends. Those times are not over. The book of Revelation tells about a vision of the heavenly Jerusalem, that city set on a mountain, that place not made by human hands, but eternal. That dwelling place of God. There he will wipe away every tear from their eyes. There shall be no more death, no more mourning, no more wailing or pain. That place is not here. We have shed and will shed many tears, but that too is passing away. In the preface to the Eucharistic prayer, The priest prays, "For your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended." That is our belief and hope for Jessica and each one of us. Our life is changed with death, not ended. Death is not the end. We will meet Jessica again. In that place for which the mountain of Jerusalem is a mere sign and symbol, we will meet her in that unseen eternal place where God will wipe every tear from our eyes and where there shall be no more death, no more mourning, no more wailing or pain. Jesus speaks to us in the gospel, "This is the will of my Father, that everyone who sees the Son and believes in him may have eternal life, and I shall raise him on the last day." My prayer for each one of us is that we take these words of the Savior to heart, just as Jessica did. What is seen is transitory and passing, but what is unseen is eternal. May we imitate Jessica's steadfast faith and come to share in the glory for which we hope.
Please stand.
God the Almighty Father raised Christ his Son from the dead. With confidence we ask him to save all his people, living and dead.
Our response is, Lord, hear our prayer. For Jessica, who in baptism was given the pledge of eternal life, that she may now be admitted to the company of the saints, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our sister who ate the body of Christ, the bread of life, that she may be raised up on the last day, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear us.
For our deceased relatives and friends, and for all who have helped us, that they may have the reward of their goodness, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear us.
For those who have fallen asleep in the hope of rising again, that they may see God face to face, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear us.
For the family and friends of our sister Jessica, that they may be consoled in their grief by the Lord who wept at the death of his friend, Lazarus, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us assembled here to worship in faith, that we may be gathered together again in God's kingdom, we pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear our prayer. God, our shelter and our strength, you listen in love to the cry of your people. Hear the prayers we offer for our departed brothers and sisters. Cleanse them of their sins and grant them the fullness of redemption. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated. Please stand.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice endures, may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice of your hands for the praise and the glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Look favorably on your offerings, O Lord, so that your departed servant Jessica may be taken up into glory with your Son, in whose great mystery of love we are all united, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna.
Please kneel if you're able, or be seated.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, By the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim, by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant, Francis our Pope, and Peter our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Remember your servant Jessica, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she who was united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth he will raise up in the flesh those who have died and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters too, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you are God as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages, and praise you without end. Through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
Please stand.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, power, and glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with you too.
Please kneel and be seated.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I'm not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Catholics believe that what was once bread and wine have been changed into the true body and blood of Jesus Christ, and that our sharing in the Holy Communion is the sign of our oneness and unity in the Catholic Church. We invite Catholics who are prepared and properly disposed to receive Holy Communion today to come forward at this time. Others present not receiving Holy Communion may come forward for a blessing. Please just indicate that by crossing your arms. Or you're certainly free to remain in your pew and pray for the peaceful repose of Jessica's soul and for her family.
Joyful lips, we sing to you our praise and gratitude that you should count us worthy, Lord, to share this heavenly food. You satisfy the hungry heart with
you.
know your life. On earth was troubled, and only you could know the pain. You weren't afraid to face the devil. You were no stranger to the rain. Go rest high on that mountain. Yes, your work on earth is done. Go to heaven a shouting. Love for the Father and the Son. Oh, how we cried the day you left us. We gathered round your grave to grieve. Wish I could see the angels' faces when they hear your sweet voice sing. Go rest high on that mountain. Yes, your work on earth is done. Go to love for the Father and the Son. Go rest high on that mountain. Love for the Father and the Son.
Please stand.
Let us pray. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that your servant Jessica, for whom we have celebrated this Paschal sacrament, may pass over to a dwelling place of light and peace through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated, and I would invite Reverend Paul Sink to deliver our eulogy.
Jessica and I met in 1996. When she climbed into a 15-passenger van as a teenage participant of the Teens Camping Tour of the West. I had the privilege, the great privilege, of being a staff member for this 23-day van camping tour of the United States that is truly an adventure of self-discovery while discovering America. The basic principles of TCTW are stated in these terms. In the end, life is really quite simple. Love yourself, love others, appreciate nature. Use your unique gifts to make the world a better place, all while giving praise to your Maker. What a joy it has been watching Jessica live into and fully embrace all of these aspects of her life with the tremendous heart of a servant. So many of the things that helped the 44 of us on that TCTW trip fall in love with our new friend are the very things that she carried into every relationship in her life. That's why all of you, all of us, are here today. The love she shared, the dedication she brought to everything she did, the heart that she poured into the lives of those close to her, all of these endearing qualities and so many more are hallmarks of Jessica. She had a radiant smile. I don't have to tell you that. It just drew you in and made you smile right back. You could not help it. But that smile was only the surface of her charm and wit. There was a healthy measure of wit. Ah, you know her. If you were lucky, that smile would frequently lead to that beautifully infectious laughter. Oh, that laughter. And when Jessica laughed, you knew it. It was a head-back affair, mouth-wide-open laugh that was just as contagious as her smile. And thankfully, it didn't take too much to get her laughing. But some of her favorite laughable moments were certainly those spent with family. She loved to laugh along with Mark and their kids, as well as at wider family gatherings with parents, her brother Jason and his lovely family. Laughter and love went hand in hand for Jessica when she spent time with family and friends. Her love and dedication to Mark and their children was unparalleled and rooted in their faith. From the first time she met Mark, she knew that she had found her person. Her person to spend life with. She fully embraced their life of being a firefighting family. While Mark served his position as engineer, she served in the auxiliary. She truly loved the life they had built together. And she let that huge heart of a servant shine so brightly. They always enjoyed their family times together, especially when they were able to attend the Grandfather Mountain and the Loch Norman Highland Games. Those communities and all the activities and friendships that were part of those experiences were made so much more rich as they shared them with Caleb and Connor and Piper and Mason. One of the seemingly magical things about Jessica was her ability, and you've probably seen this, her ability to walk into a room and make you feel like you were her closest friend and that you were all the better for it because your heart knew it. A true servant of the Lord can bring that gift of caring, compassionate connection to almost any interaction. And Jessica did just that, living out her faith in every relationship, making sure to lift up all of God's children whom she encountered. This also made her a great team player, whether it was in the athletics that she loved or in her many experiences under the umbrella of the YMCA, and also through her sorority connections, that family at Appalachian State. In these and so many other settings, Jessica's involvement made all the difference for everyone involved. And let me just tell you, everyone to Jessica meant everyone. Mark shared with me that some years ago, the two of them were driving around and they found themselves behind a retail shopping center. And all of a sudden, Jessica had Mark stop the car, and she grabbed that bag of change from the console. We all have one of those. But she grabbed the bag of change from the console and just hopped out of the car. "I'll be right back, Mark," He didn't know what was going on, but following her with his eyes, he saw her walk over to a man who was obviously homeless, sitting on a nearby wall. And she plunked that big bag of change down in his lap, and then she knelt and took his hand and prayed with him. She came back to the car and told Mark that it had been a calling to her to do that, that she just felt God telling her that he needed prayer. That, my friends, was how Jessica lived her call, her calling from God, to serve, to be about service above herself, and to truly live the life of a servant. I'll close with a brief story from the summer of 1996, as was recounted in our trip journal. Yes, we even made teenagers write a journal. And so in the account for day 5 of our TCTW adventure, we had gotten the news that a close friend from home of one of our van mates had died from a car accident. The way we surrounded our new friend in her grief was a moment that changed this special group of teenagers that Jessica was a part of. As we gathered the group to share this terrible news, we were standing in a circle at the Four Corners Monument. There's something I've learned as a pastor. People hear things and remember things that I never remember saying. One of those was recorded in this trip journal, because apparently I told the gathered group words that ring true today. Now is the time we have to pull together and be strong. We have to help each other. And as one of Jessica's best friends wrote in this journal entry for our van that day, Molly put it in these terms. Excuse me. She wrote that we as a group now carried that love that whispered to us, I'll be there for you whenever you need me. Those were the words of a teenager. Her interpretation of our circle of love and faith. Jessica carried that loving, supportive presence into every arena of life. She was always there when we needed her, even when her wick was growing dim. But even when that wick has gone out, her light, the light that she shared, shines so brightly in each one of us, in her beautiful family, in all of you friends and community gathered here. And it shines brightly to remind us to find the strength to help each other and to be there for each other. Because ocular melanoma does not get to have her last word. Her beautiful life of faith and love is the lasting word of Jessica. Well done, good and faithful servant. Amen.
Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our sister. May our farewell express our affection for her. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet her again, when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself.
In paradiso, de docante angeli, into adventu, suscipiat te martires, et per docante in civitatem sanctam, Jerusalem, chorus angelorum, te suscipiat, et cum Lazaro quondam papere aeterna.
Into your hands, Father of Mercies, we commend our sister Jessica, in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, she will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon Jessica in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant, and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith, until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with our sister forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. In the sure hope of the resurrection, we take leave of our sister. Let us go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
Sing the love of mercy.
you all.